Hey, welcome back, you guys. It's Carlos. So we have some more Neo Geo Battle Coliseum matches for you. So we have a team of Kim Kafwan and Shermi versus a team of K-Dash and Chonshu. So I'm starting off with Kim because I feel he is my better character of these two. But so far I've lost about maybe 50% health already, and I'm not doing too much work. So I switch over to Shermi to possibly do some work with her. The thing I noticed with Chonshu is that that character has some pretty quick weak attacks. Much better than what Shermi has, because her crouching A is pretty good, but you gotta be really close to it. Now, however, her crouching B is what you want to use to cancel into forward B. But it has slow startup, but it's got good range, you know? So you've got to try to actually balance the two properly. But I mostly try to use crouching B most of the time. Even sometimes when I know I shouldn't be using it, it's just a habit, really. So I bring in Kim to try to get some health back with Shermi while she's in the background. Did you see that? I actually crouched with Kim right under Chonshu's fireball. And that's kind of weird because I didn't think Kim Kafwan can crouch that low to the ground. And, you know, when we look at the height of Chonshu, I mean, that character is already small. So that was kind of interesting. So we bring in Shermi and I leap over her and get her into a back suplex. And you can actually get three more hits with the back suplex if you keep pushing punch repeatedly after the first back suplex actually lands. So anyway, so he tries to get me with a super, but I block it and give him a full punish combo into a super. I flip over, give him another back suplex, add three more hits just to get a few little pixels of damage in there. So he brings in Chonshu, and I'm still in here with Shermi. I think this would be a good time to switch out Shermi, but not yet. Okay, so I stay in there, get a combo with a super, leap over, do a back suplex again, get some more hits for chip damage, and now I change over to Kim Kafwan. He missed the timing of his combos, so when he comes down, go into a standing fierce hit into a super directly. Dash in, go into crouching A two times, go into his three Rekka hits, and cancel into his super, and he's down and in the corner. He wakes up with a team super, but I actually got hit at the same time. But it didn't matter because I still killed him. So he actually hits me with the dragon, finally! I tried to do an air super, it didn't work. We tried again, we nail him this time. The problem with that super in the air is it tends to trade with a lot of jumping attacks. So it's not the best thing to use, but sometimes you can catch someone with it. So he's using some low attacks with Chonshu, trying to keep me out, because his low attacks are much better than Shermi's. Hers, you gotta be really close or a little bit far. So I actually tried to chip him with the lightning knee super. It didn't work. I tried to chip him out. It's not enough. He still has a little super, well, a little energy actually. So I've got one super meter, might as well burn it and kill him with the lightning knee super. So that was a pretty good first match. Alright, nice one. So now we're going to move on to the next one. So this is a team of Rock and a team of Neo Geo. This is a very odd team I've never really used together. I wanted to use Neo Geo just for the hell of it. I think he's a pretty neat character, but one thing I do want to mention is in World Heroes 2, he had this uppercut backflip move as an anti-air. It was extremely good. But in this game, it's extremely slow and it has almost no range, so he really lost that ability to use that special move as an anti-air. What you saw there was actually a command grab. He actually has two variations. One of them is a fire, which is meant for big damage. The other is an ice one, which is meant to freeze the opponent. And from there, as you saw, you can go into a super move right after. Preferably, the fire one is pretty good for big damage if you don't have any super meter. But if you have super meter, just use the ice one, because right there the opponent is open for like maybe a second, so you have time to go into a super move right away. So I'm constantly jumping on his Mr. Karate, just jumping with Fierce Cape because it does multiple hits on the way down. So I get him with a level 3 super and we get to see Neo Gigas make an appearance once again. We haven't seen Neo Gigas since I believe World Heroes 2. I believe that's the last time I saw him. So he's using Cyber Wu now. This character is actually a command grab character, like Zangief in a way. I believe he has one super that does a bunch of projectiles, which is this one. But I'm not sure what the other one is. But I find this character a little bit slow, but his command grab is actually really, really strong. But I don't think he was familiar with that character, so Neo Dio actually takes that match. He did most of the work. So on to the final match. My best team versus, I guess, his best team. So I'm starting off with Hanzo and King Lion versus his team of Genjuro and Neo Dio. So I'm familiar with this Genjuro. I know that cross-up slash is coming, so I've got to be very careful not to stay on the ground too much. If I am going to stay on the ground, I've got to try to bait out the cross-up slash thing, and possibly do some jumping or do a bit more projectiles or maybe some low attacks or something. So he switches over to Neo Dio so his Genjuro can get some health regenerated. So I want to try to maintain some pressure on his Neo Dio because he's really good for jumping attacks, as you see right there. So when he lands, he misses the timing, so I go into a counter, which he gets hit by. So you can counter King Lion's, you can actually do his counter and cancel any of his first four hits, I believe, in the counter and cancel it into a super. So he's doing that freaking spinning attack very frequently with Neo Dio. So I switch over back to King Lion because Hanzo was not doing work there against Neo Dio. Not at all. Okay, one thing with King Lion is he jumps extremely high, similar to Bison from Street Fighter 2. He jumps too high, and I think that gives too much away from his jump-in options, really. So he actually nails me with the super right there for some big damage. So right now would be a good time to get a counter, and he actually gets into it. So I switch over to Hanzo just in time to save my King Lion. So we're going to put some work in with Hanzo. Just throw some shurikens, try to take some life off from a distance just for the meantime. Because Neo Dio only has a projectile in super meter format, so he doesn't have a standard one. However, the CPU control that Neo Dio does have a projectile, and I believe it has super move properties, so it actually goes through standard projectiles, I believe, or they cancel each other. Point is, the CPU has a better version of these boss characters. So I block his uppercut on wake up and I give him a decent damaging 3-hit combo. He was trying to go into a super, but my low hit actually canceled it. So he's down to his last character, which is Neo Dio, so I bring in King Lion because he's got a shitload of health. So I'm trying to hit him with the freaking energy waves there, and then I finish him off with a super. Cannot block, cannot dodge. That's it, good game. Thanks for watching, guys.